Admit it, you had Pac-Man fever. This is VH1's One Hit Wonders. Goofy Greats.
Now, Frank, you're 1-9, this here's a rubber duck. You got a copy on me, big fan, come on.
They're the novelty acts who were novel enough to hit it big once.
Hey Mo, hey Mo!
It was a hit. Whether it was a dumb song or not, I'm happy about that.
They act as the blueprint for an earlier time, if you can remember how to read them.
Breaker 1-9 means that you're trying to break in on Channel 19.
And look at it this way, it could have been a whole lot worse.
We could have had done songs like, I had sex with your mother and it was so much fun, but we didn't want to go for cheap jokes.
Hi, I'm William Shatner, and I love today's category. If you think about it, it's where some of the truest one-hit wonders reside. Single moments of inspiration derived from singular events, odes to the cultural minutiae of American life, like streaking or talking ducks. That's right, we are counting down the greatest novelty songs. We start with a song about a debilitating illness that leaves its victims muttering, waka, waka, waka.
The cultural saturation of the 80s video game revolution would not have been complete without a one-hit wonder novelty song. Luckily, Buckner and Garcia were there to infect us all with Pac-Man fever.
Pac-Man fever!
Pac-Man fever!
It's driving me crazy!
Jerry Buckner and Gary Garcia were struggling Atlanta musicians who spotted something new in their favorite watering hole after a recording session.
There was this little machine over in the corner, and we didn't know what it was. And we went over and started playing. Of course, it was a Pac-Man machine, and we got hooked on it.
I got a pocket full of quarters, and I'm headed to the arcade.
They also got an idea, capitalizing on a trend that was sweeping the nation. They wrote the song in 3 hours, recorded it, and began making the rounds of the record companies.
We got probably more than a dozen turned-down letters from all these people, saying that they didn't think that it was a hit record.
Undaunted, Buckner and Garcia had the record press themselves and slipped a copy to a local DJ who played it on the air. The response was immediate. CBS Records quickly signed the duo and sent them back into the studio to record an album's worth of video game theme songs.
'Cause I got Pac-Man fever.
Pac-Man fever.
It's driving me crazy.
Then we had to write and produce 7 more video game songs in 3 weeks, so it was a real fiasco. We would go out every night to arcades looking at games and writing the songs.
The single sold millions of copies and ironically helped keep CBS Records in the black during a time of depressed music sales, as teenagers spent their money on video games instead of records.
Hey, I was always great, but when I got this Pac-Man Fever album, I became inspired.
A song about a fad is dooming you to one-hit wonder status, because once you're that band with the Pac-Man Fever song, what, are you going to move out of the 80s?
Indeed, after their initial success, the duo found the record company unwilling to release their new material.
I think they decided to themselves, why invest more money in these guys? We've made a lot of money in this project, and let's just keep it and go home with our money and forget about it.
Buckner and Garcia moved on from there as well. The duo continued writing and recording their own music and supporting themselves with radio jingles and session work. But everything old is new again, and the millennium seems to have brought with it a wave of nostalgia for Pac-Man and other 80s video games. Buckner and Garcia have re-released their CD and are entertaining thoughts of a tour.
The Simpsons.
TV's favorite animated family crossed over from the small screen to pop stardom in 1992 when the ever-impish Bart Simpson implored us all to do the Bartman. The Bartman was the product of a surprising collaboration between Michael Jackson and the Simpsons creative team. Jackson, a huge fan of the show, contacted producers and offered to co-write and sing backup on the planned album. Thus was born the Bartman.
I'm the kid that made the thing with C and R. Last name Simpson, first name Bart.
It's not only funny, but it's irresistible as far as dancing. And I think it just captures the whole Simpson spirit through, from the Bart angle. And I think that's the way to go. I predict number one on that one.
Well, it didn't quite hit number one, but luckily, Bart always kept his day job.
Will you stop that infernal racket?
was known as Vern Castle, Larry Love, and Derry Dover, but it was as Tiny Tim that he tiptoed his way into everlasting fame as a one-hit wonder.
Oh, tiptoe through the tulips with me.
Born Herbert Corey, Tiny Tim was a devotee of 1920s Tin Pan Alley songs, and his recording of Tiptoe Through the Tulips became an unexpected hit in 1968.
And if I kiss you in the garden, in the moon.
It was a magical moment, and Tiny Tim made many other wonderful records, but that was the only one that, shall we say, broke through and became a mega hit.
Tiny further and forever entered the annals of popular culture when he got married on The Tonight Show. More than 45 million people tuned in to see the top-heavy tunesmith tie the knot. Tiny carefully tended the waning flame of his fame throughout the next three decades, continuously performing his one and only hit.
It's the only hit I've had, and I will never let myself get tired of it. Never bite the hand that feeds me.
Tiny Tim died of heart failure in 1996.
Tiptoe through the tulips with me.
You'll notice that this next group is all guys. That's just the way it is. Some things just don't seem to translate between the sexes so well. I don't understand why. I personally think the eye poke, is gender blind.
In 1984, Chicago-based rhythm and blues outfit Jumpin' the Saddle Band scored their one and only hit with a loving tribute to the Three Stooges called the Curly Shuffle.
Hey Mo, hey Mo,
hey Mo, hey Mo.
Well, yuck.
The Curly Shuffle was the brainchild of lead singer Peter Quinn, who spent years in front of the television studying the moves of his favorite stooge.
I like Curly a lot, and I would do antics of Curly antics, you know. Yuck, yuck. You know, just regular Curly stuff.
Performing the shuffle in public for the first time gave Quinn the opportunity to display his full range of Curlyisms. The response was instantaneous.
We were playing at a big festival in Milwaukee, and 5,000 people out there dancing and just going crazy, doing all the Three Stooges antics, I mean, poking each other in the eyes, they're skipping backwards, doing the shuffle, rolling around on the ground like Curly used to do.
It didn't take long for the Curly Shuffle to catch the ears of an adoring Stooges-obsessed public, turning the song, if not the band, into a top 20 success.
We do the Curly Shuffle.
What'd you say?
We do the Curly Shuffle.
Capitalizing on Curly's success, Jumpin' the Saddle Band released a full-length album, but it went nowhere. Not surprisingly, their label wanted another goofy hit.
They wanted us to come up with another novelty song. I really didn't want to do it. I think that Atlantic Records resented that, so that's why we kind of parted ways.
Label-less but unscathed, Chicago's hardest working bar band returned to what they did best.
We had played together for 10 or 12 years, and we continued to do that afterwards, too.
So do the Curly Shuffle.
Today, while Quinn remains busy fronting the rock blues band Skip Town and the Greyhounds, it's clear the spirit of Curly is never far away.
Well, there is a resemblance going on, and I think the older I get, I've been cursed by Curly. Curly died in January of 1952. I was born in January of 1952. Curly is alive and living in my body.
Started out in Port Charlestown. Frank Smith's mom used to hang around.
In the early 80s, General Hospital ruled the airwaves of daytime TV. It was only a matter of time before someone decided to sing about it, which the Afternoon Delights did with their kitschy hit, General Hospital. Afternoon Delights was the brainchild of producer Harry King and Boston DJ Lisa Lips. The duo capitalized on the emerging trend of rap music and the booming popularity of soap operas.
General Hospital was huge. Luke and Laura, the Quartermain Clan, just high drama. So I guess there had to be a song about it.
Well, Luke, you got another job. The Quartermains are the brand new mob. Laura's the receptionist. What's missing now is the Ice Princess.
Name-checking General Hospital's most famous characters, the song hit the top 40 in 1981 and promptly disappeared into the one-hit wonder novelty bin.
I just can't cope without my soap.
Coming up, the song the seafood industry doesn't want you to hear. That's next on VH1's One Hit Wonders.
I heard the
best of the best we're gonna be.
Right here on VH1.
Hi, I'm Liza.
And I'm David.
David.
We've been practicing a long time for this day.
You guys are killers, rapists, robbers.
Is there a law against loud
music? Oh, gnarly!
I'm with the Goo Goo Dolls, and we're at the home of their number one fan.
Oh, what we can do with this place.
My favorite love song,
Fall in Love.
You're gonna get laid.
Yeah!
Ready for this?
Right here on VH1. Keep watching.
Reviewing our last fiscal year, the numbers from January were slightly better than the numbers from February. However, the numbers in January were identical to the numbers in March. The numbers in April were slightly lower than the numbers in March, but identical.
Like playing games? Come to Best Buy, where you can play the latest video games and try out a lot of other cool stuff. Best Buy. Go ahead, turn on the fun.
Here we go.
Tomorrow, Disney's most enchanting movie is back.
It's wonderful.
With an all-new musical sequence, Human Again. Beauty and the Beast Special Edition on video and for the first time on Disney DVD tomorrow.
I want to get the weight off.
And keep it off.
Introducing all-natural Dexatrim Results. Nutrition-based Results combines antioxidants, vitamins, minerals, 6 natural energy sources, and fat burners.
The weight stayed off.
I finally did it.
New Dexatrim Results. Look better, feel better getting there.
I have combination skin. It's hard to find makeup with the ideal balance. I want matte here. I want moisture there. I found the ideal makeup.
Finally, L'Oreal creates Ideal Balance. It's first intelligent makeup to balance combination skin. Micro sponges mattify oily zones for hours. The hydrating complex keeps dry zones moisturized. The complexion is matte, flawless, and even.
The ideal balance.
New Ideal Balance, the first balancing makeup for combination skin by L'Oreal Paris.
Because you're worth it.
That's a big fish.
Do you realize you're attempting to purify quite possibly the purest air on the planet?
What did you have for lunch?
Tuna.
That really helps.
Quadra Air Purifier. Delta ticket to Alaska. Just 2 of the hundreds of rewards built into the new American Express card.
Say ah!
Acura RSX, one of Car and Driver's 10 best for 2002.
From law school to the law firm, they've been everything to each other.
You're ready, and you can do this.
But this fall, if they're gonna make it in a man's world...
Give me one reason why I shouldn't fire you.
I have 3 reasons. I'm just trying to decide which one to go with.
I'll take the top 2.
They'll do it together. From Emmy-winning creator David E. Kelley, if you're not part of the club, make your own.
Are we drinking? Oh, yeah.
Girls Club premieres this month on Fox.
Katie Burke lives in fear of a man everyone else thinks is dead.
My old boyfriend's back. He's been watching me.
On October 18th...
I know, wait, look what happens.
She's the only one who can stop him.
Wherever you go, I can follow.
Katie Holmes.
Why are you doing this?
Benjamin Bratt.
What are you going to do about it?
Move on with my life.
Abandon. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, October 18th, everywhere.
Hello, my
Kellogg's Special K Red Berries. It's got its own crunchy flake and strawberries right inside the box. Special K Red Berries. Looking good, never tasted so great.
An anti-aging breakthrough. In testing, 100% of women who tried Neutrogena Visibly Firm showed a visible improvement in firmness, fine lines, or clarity. Visibly Firm replenishes copper, a collagen-building mineral essential for firm skin. Neutrogena Visibly Firm.
What do you think of the greatest one-hit wonders? Tell us on VH1.com's One Hit Wonders message board. I was offered a soup like this once at a Turkish restaurant. They'll tell you, the head's where the flavor is, but I couldn't get past that big open mouth. And that eye staring up at me, I passed out.
Oh.
Danger, Will Robinson recorded a song, and it's about fish heads.
Fish heads, fish heads, roly-poly fish heads, fish heads, fish heads, eat them up, yum.
Child actor Bill Mumy found stardom on the late 60s TV series Lost in Space. But when the show was canceled, he returned to that tried-and-true actor's first love, music. He and childhood friend Robert Hamer formed Barnes & Barnes in the late 70s and adopted alter ego personalities as part of the novelty act.
Barnes & Barnes was basically formed as a way to release excess, kind of less than normal musical energy.
They can't play baseball, they don't wear sweaters, they're not good dancers.
They don't play drums.
Fish Heads was born in a Los Angeles Chinese restaurant when the Barnes boys ordered fish for lunch.
We didn't know that it was going to come prepared to the table with the head still on the body. And in our demented minds, we looked at it and said, a fish head, a roly-poly fish head.
And thus a novelty classic was born. The boys recorded the song and promptly sent their creation to Dr. Demento, radio's novelty enthusiast. It remains the most requested song ever on a syndicated radio show. And for good measure, they gave him a cameo in the video. But the tale gets fishier still with the involvement of Bill Paxton. The then-struggling actor was a friend and directed the video that became an MTV favorite.
Roly-poly fish heads are never seen drinking cappuccino in Italian restaurants with Oriental women.
Both Mumy and Hamer continue to make music a big part of their post-Fishhead lives, all the while retaining a healthy sense of humor about their musical claim to fame.
Music has always been a passion with me. It's the most important thing in my world, except for the bag that Robert's wearing right now, which I covet and I hope he'll give me after this shoot.
Absolutely. Anything for you, son.
Me and my fish heads watching one-hit wonders on VH1. It's oh so sad. Yeah.
Wear sunscreen now. Enjoy the power and beauty of your youth.
In 1999, the success of the spoken word hit Everybody's Free to Wear Sunscreen by filmmaker Baz Luhrmann set off a firestorm of speculation about the origins of its inspirational wisdom.
Don't be reckless with other people's hearts. Don't put up with people who are reckless with yours. Floss.
In an elaborate email hoax which circulated the globe, the feel-good advice was rumored to be an MIT commencement speech given by author Kurt Vonnegut that eventually made its way into the hands of the Moulin Rouge director.
Baz Luhrmann, looking for things to put on his album, read online this speech about living a good life and wearing sunscreen.
Live in New York City once, but leave before it makes you huff.
Turns out the mock address was the handiwork of Chicago Tribune reporter Mary Schmeek.
At every stage, when I think that this story couldn't get any weirder, it gets a little bit weirder.
But the strange circumstances only added to the song's appeal and sent it up the Billboard charts.
Dance.
Today, the creators of Everybody's Free have returned to their day jobs, but the perpetrator of the prank that turned a newspaper column into a pop hit remains at large.
But trust me, on the sunscreen.
Gonna clean my room until I got high.
Just say no? Well, not exactly. In 2001, everybody was getting a contact high from Afro Man Stoner Classic, Because I Got High, uniting potheads and procrastinators alike with his tales of domestic dawdling.
I was gonna go to court before I got high. I was gonna pay my child support, but then I got high.
No, you wasn't.
That song is about the bad things that will happen to you if you smoke pot. And yet, the amount you like that song is directly related to how often you smoke marijuana.
Dimebag philosophies aside, Because I Got High soon found its way into the soundtrack for Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, helping Afro Man, aka Joseph Foreman, score a mammoth international hit, even though he got high.
Because I got high, because I got high. Because I got high.
Having earned a Grammy nomination and a place in the pantheon of stoned out standards, not surprisingly, Afro Man took a little break. But perhaps one day he'll heed his own message and come up with another hit.
I was thinking, how hard can writing a novelty song be? Maybe I'll write one about TV shows that have countdowns in them. It'll be on this show next year. As for today's top song, you're going to have to come back for that piece of info. We'll be right back.
For the ultimate music destination, log on to VH1.com or AOL keyword VH1. Never be in the dark. Check out VH1.com's comprehensive news area to get the latest music news on your favorite bands and artists. Go to AOL keyword VH1 or VH1.com.
When I'm in my car, I am sheer perfection.
I feel like a wolf.
Well, that's the only time I get the love from the ladies.
Stereo up, two windows down.
I'm flying.
Checking everything out.
I'm saving a little bit of Mother Earth.
Speed racer chick.
I'm the DJ. Don't touch my stereo and don't lower my bass.
Go anywhere.
I'm going to Broadway, baby.
New Orleans.
New Orleans.
Miami.
Miami.
Drive one of Toyota's 18 different models.
When I'm in my car, I look good.
Feels like good things are coming your way.
I'm going to find my mojo.
Sorry about that. Hey, if you're gonna make a collect call, be sure to dial in the center with 1-800-CALL-ATT. Let's show 'em, gang.
1-800-CALL-ATT.
Free for you and cheap for them. Watch this. Ladder.
Save on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
This fall, college students everywhere will achieve scholastic excellence. This is not their story. Comedy Central Original Movies presents the true story of five Ivy League students with one lofty ambition.
We could really have a lot of sex.
They take on the man.
He's called the Lincoln Trump.
They take on the school.
We will get those perverts.
And discover what it really takes to be happy.
I don't have to die a virgin.
It's Comedy Central's first original movie, Corn and Chicken, premiering Sunday, October 13th at 10, only on Comedy Central.
Reviewing our last fiscal year, the numbers from January were slightly better than the numbers from February. However, the numbers in January were identical to the numbers in March. The numbers in April were slightly lower than the numbers in March, but identical.
Like playing games? Come to Best Buy, where you can play the latest video games and try out a lot of other cool stuff. Best Buy. Go ahead, turn on the fun.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. Went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.
These are the final days of the JCPenney Fall 100th Anniversary Sale. It's your last chance for the lowest prices of the season store-wide with new super values through Saturday.
It's all inside.
JCPenney.
It takes three ways to protect yourself against breast cancer.
A breast exam by a doctor or a nurse.
A breast self-exam.
And a mammogram.
Ask your doctor about what age and how often you should be examined.
One way is not enough.
Two ways are not enough.
We should know.
It took three ways for us to become breast cancer survivors.
Stop breast cancer for life.
Lifetime knows what women want, and our new network, Lifetime Real Women, delivers more of it.
I love taking care of people.
More true stories.
I feel certain obligations to my patients. They're like an extended family.
More real-life experiences.
This is my community. This is my home.
Lifetime Real Women, a new network from Lifetime. No one knows the world of women better.
Lifetime Real Women, now available on digital cable from Time Warner.
Deuce and KFC's Hot and Fresh Breast Meal. With your choice of individual side, a freshly baked biscuit, and a medium drink. There's fast food, then there's KFC. Get it to go and eat it while you watch VH1's All Access. Next.
One way to get a novelty hit is to take an existing craze and just, you know, tweak it in little and subtle ways until you find the perfect formula for pop smash status. The other way is talk funny and put on a giant duck suit.
In 1976, Memphis morning DJ Rick Dees released the parody Disco Duck Part 1 at the height of the dance craze, proving that just about anything with a disco beat could be a hit.
All the ladies were treating me right.
Disco Duck, how could you not like Disco Duck? Come on. You know, it's a guilty pleasure.
Look at me, I'm the Disco Duck.
And I'm glad there wasn't a part 2 to that.
Disco Duck.
It It wasn't long after Disco Duck hit number one that the disco backlash began, and everyone, including Deez, was running for cover and doing spin control.
Disco Duck was voted the worst song of the 70s, and that's the song that made me get shock treatment.
Deez follow-up novelties never generated the lift of the duck, and the DJ shifted gears to TV with a hosting stint on Solid Gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rick Deez.
These days, Rick Deez lets the professionals make the music, sticking to DJing a nationally syndicated Top 40 Countdown show from L.A. And Disco Duck remains a zany reminder to anyone about to cash in on a trend.
Thank you so very much.
So I suppose there were lots of songs about the telephone back in the early 1900s, and our number one song is basically another example of that. Except this phone is helping a gear jammer haul 100 tons of seed corn to Frisco by sunup with 18 wheels a humming. Yeah, man.
Breaker 19, this here's a rubber duck. You got a copy on me, Big Ben? Come on.
Drawing inspiration from a burgeoning trucker culture and its distinctive CB radio lingo, C.W. McCall's Convoy took an 18-wheeler ride up the pop charts in 1976.
Convoy.
It was the dark of the moon on the 6th of June in a Kenworth pulling logs. Cab over Pete with a reefer on and a Jimmy hauling hogs.
Truckers are the salt of the earth, and C.W. McCall captured the essence of the American trucker with that song.
But the man who made trucker talk cool wasn't even a real person. C.W. McCall was a fictional character who made his first appearance in a series of bread commercials created by ad exec Bill Freeze and his songwriting partner Chip Davis.
And then she handed me an old home burger, a pretty pink tray, nice fresh bun.
That commercial started running on TV and was so well received that the TV Guide actually started printing the times that this commercial was going to run.
Old home is good buns.
Following the success of the commercials, the duo began releasing under the C.W. McCall moniker.
He'd been listening to these truck drivers talking out there. I remember him calling me up and saying, you know, they're using all these code words and all this lingo out there. It sounds like there's a war going on out there. Maybe we ought to write a song about it.
Yeah, them Smokies as thick as bugs on a bumper. They even had a bear in the air. I says, calling all trucks, says, here's the duck. We about to go a-hunting bear.
Most of us who weren't even old enough to drive at the time memorized every word of that monologue. It was beautiful.
With the release of the album Black Bear Road, Convoy went to number one on the pop and country charts, propelled by the nationwide CB radio craze.
It became like a theme song for that whole thing. I mean, the companies that made CB radios really, really loved it.
I understand that you really are a CB operator.
Oh, that's a big 10-4.
That's a big 10-4. And you really are the rubber duck.
That's my handle. I says right so on my belt buckle here.
Convoy's story of renegade trucker Rubber Duck and his 18-wheeler Anarchy also inspired a 1978 movie of the same name, starring Kris Kristofferson and Ally McGraw.
I says, Pink Ben, this here's a rubber duck. We just ain't going to pay no toll. So we crashed the gate doing 90.
By the late 70s, the CB craze began to fade. Bill Freeze retired the trucker persona and moved to Ouray, Colorado, where he was elected mayor in 1982. And Chip Davis quit country music, forming platinum-selling new age outfit Mannheim Steamroller. But even today, CW remains a mythic figure to all those trucking across the USA.
They probably identified with what the song was saying. CW McCall's our hero.
We gone, bye-bye.
I don't think people really understand the impact a good novelty song can have on our daily lives, like Convoy. I heard someone say, time to put the hammer down, just this morning on my way here. I rarely ever say I understand anymore. It's always 10-4. Hey, Bill, what's your 20? Rolling to the studio. Come on, now. That's staying power. I sure could use a 10-100. Excuse me.
Breaker 19.
Live from Radio City Music Hall, Tuesday, October 15th at 9, 8 Central, the VH1 Vogue Fashion Awards, hosted by Deborah Messing. Get ready.
Well, mercy sake. tastes good, buddy. We're gonna back on out here, so keep the buttons off your glass and the bears off your...